everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet this beautifully textured ridged round ripple blanket. Now for my blanket on the table, I used a 4mm crochet hook and just under 2 balls of the Hobbii Horizon acrylic cakes. Now I've brought my camera down to a very unusual angle just so you can see the beautiful texture in this blanket. For the tutorial itself, I'll be demonstrating with a 4.5mm crochet hook just so you can see the stitches a little bit better. To begin, we're going to start with a magic ring, and from that magic ring you're going to chain 2. Now this chain 2 counts as your very first double crochet stitch. Now into the magic ring, place 11 double crochet stitches, American term double crochet, so yarn over, go into the magic ring, pull up a loop, you'll have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. So you have your chain 2 that counts as your first stitch. Then your second double crochet here, we need 10 more for a total of 12 stitches, including that chain 2. Now before you do anything else, just double check you have 12 stitches including this chain 2 at the end. The count for a 12 point round ripple is very important, so you have to make sure that in these beginning rows we're getting the correct amount of stitches for the ripple to work. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 including that chain 2. So we're going to slip stitch to join to the top of that chain 2. So just pop your hook in, do a little slip stitch, then you're good to go ahead and tighten up this magic ring at the back. For round 2, chain 2, which counts as your first double crochet stitch, and all the chain 2s for the rest of this pattern count as your first double crochet. And then into that exact same place that you just slip stitched and chained from, just here, I'm pulling it apart, place a double crochet stitch. Now place 2 double crochet stitches into the next stitch. That's 1 and 2, both going into the exact same place, and place 2 double crochet stitches in each of these double crochets around. At the end of round two, you should have 24 stitches. Now slip stitch to the top of that chain two. And the second round is complete. For round three, chain two to start, then skip a stitch and into the next, we're going to work a small shell. Now a small shell is double crochet, chain two and double crochet all into the same stitch. So you're creating a little V. This is our small shell. Skip a stitch, small shell in the next, which is double crochet, chain two, double crochet, all into the same place. Skip a stitch, small shell in the next, and we're going to repeat this all the way around until the last section back over here where we started. So keep going, skip a stitch, small shell into the next. Once you've finished your last small shell of the round, you'll notice we have this chain two here, which leads to nothing. So we need to make this into a small shell as well. So how we do that and to end the row is working into the same place where you chained from, pop a double crochet, chain two, and then slip stitch to the top of this original chain two of the round. So again, counting is very important. So for here, you want to have 12 of these small shells. It might be easier to count the chain two spaces in between. So ignoring these small gaps here, just these chain two ones up the top, you should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and the 12th that you just formed. For round four, you want to slip stitch into this chain two space of the small shell. And into this chain two space is where we're going to put our next lot of stitches. So chain two, which counts as your first double crochet stitch, place another double crochet into that exact same place, chain two, and work two double crochet stitches back into that same chain two space. This is a large shell. A large shell is formed with two double crochet, chain two, two double crochet. So we have a small shell beneath, which is one double crochet, chain two, one double crochet, and a large shell on top, two double crochet, chain two, two double crochet. We're going to be working into the chain two spaces of your small shells in the row below. So ignore this gap here. You want to work into this top one here and into this chain two space, work a large shell. So two double crochet stitches. Chain two and two more double crochet stitches all into the same chain two space. Work a large shell into the remaining 10 chain two spaces. Pay careful attention that you're not working into these bottom ones, you're working into these top spaces that you formed on the row below. Once you reach the end of the round, you're going to want to work your last large shell into this small shell that we formed at the beginning and end of the very last row. Now, before we go any further, this is the time to check your stitch count. It is so easy to accidentally work into a different gap that now is the time to just triple check you're on target. You need to have 12 of these large shells in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. If you have 12, we're good to carry on. If you have less or more, now is the time to rip it back and fix it. Just pop your yarn back on your hook once you're confident you have your 12 large shells, and we're going to slip stitch to this initial chain two right at the beginning here to finish the round. For round five, start by slip stitching into the very next double crochet of the row below. So slip stitch into that very next stitch. You'll do this at the start of every single round for the rest of your blanket. You slip stitch to join to the chain two, then slip stitch into the next stitch along. Once you've done that, chain two, which counts as your first double crochet stitch and also for the rest of this pattern will count. And into your chain two space, work a large shell, just as you did in the row below. And a large shell, two double crochet, chain two, two double crochet, all into the same chain two space. Double crochet in the next stitch. skip 2 stitches. This is where we start forming the valleys between the peaks. Skip 2 stitches and work a double crochet into the next. So skip, skip, double crochet in the 3rd stitch along. Work a large shell into the chain 2 space. And double crochet into the next stitch. You'll repeat this all the way around. Skip 2 stitches, double crochet in the next. Work a large shell into the chain 2 space. Then double crochet into the next stitch. Skip 2, double crochet, large shell, double crochet. Skip 2, double crochet, large shell, double crochet, all the way around. Once you reach the end of the round and you've done your final double crochet of the row, you're going to skip 2 stitches and just slip stitch to your chain 2 of the beginning of the round. So don't worry too much about what's going on down here. You finish your final stitch of the row, skip 2 and slip stitch to that chain 2 right at the very beginning. For round 6, just as before, and as you will for every single row, slip stitch into the next stitch of the row. Just slip stitch across. So you always join with a slip stitch to the chain 2, then slip stitch into the next stitch. Chain 2, and double crochet into the next stitch. Large shell into the chain 2 space. Now we started this round with our chain 2 that counts as a stitch and a double crochet. So 1, 2 stitches before the shell in the chain 2 space. 1, 2, shell. So in turn, crochet in the next 2 stitches. So you have 2 coming up, so 2 coming down. Then just as before, skip 2 stitches and crochet into the next. And crochet into the next. You'll only have 1 stitch left, keeping it in sync with the count of 2 that you started with. Large shell into the chain 2 space. And double crochet into the next 2 stitches. If you find your shells are covering up that first double crochet, just scooch them round a little bit So double crochet in the next two. However many stitches, remembering this chain two counts as a double crochet. However many you start with before you reach the chain two space, so in this instance two, is how many you will do coming back down the other side and going up and down all the way around. So continue this pattern, skip two, double crochet in the next two stitches, large shell, double crochet in the next two, skip two, all the way round, keep going. Once you've finished your last double crochet of the round, flatten it out a little bit. We're going to slip stitch to this chain two that you started with and slip stitch into the next stitch. Round seven, the start of the first repeat row, is a little bit different to the others that we've been doing. We're going to be working back post stitches and small shells into the chain two space. So chain two to start, which counts as your first double crochet stitch. Then we are going to back post double crochet around the next two stitches. So this is your chain two that you slip stitch to. This is the stitch you then slip stitched into and chained from for this next round. So it is the next stitch along that we're going to place our first back post double crochet. So yarn over, and for a back post, bring your hook in from the back and out the other side, pushing the post of that double crochet stitch to the back. So it should look like this from the front of your work. Your yarn will already be back here waiting for you. So you can yarn over and just bring it round. So bring my hook back around that stitch and pulling it up. So we have wrapped around the post of this stitch. Then complete your double crochet as normal. Same again, back post double crochet. So coming in, pushing that post back, grab the yarn, come back through, and complete as normal. Then into the chain two space, work a small shell. Small shell is double crochet, chain two, double crochet. That's all there is to it. Now we started with one, two, three stitches before the shell. So now we need to work three stitches back down the side. Round these next three stitches, back post double crochet. One, two, three. Now my yarn has changed color. You can see how they wrap around the post of the stitch. This is what causes the ridge. Remember, however many stitches you started before you got to the chain two space, so your chain two, and however many more stitches, one, two, three in this instance, is how many you then do down the sides. And just like before, skip two stitches and then back post double crochet up the next three. Once you reach the chain 2 space, work a small shell. Double crochet, chain 2, double crochet. Continue with your back post stitches, skip 2, back post, small shell, all the way around the blanket. Once you've finished your last few back post stitches, join with a slip stitch to the initial chain 2 of the round. And then, of course, slip stitch into the next double crochet, ready to begin round 8. Now, it's worth just taking a moment if you lift up your loop and pull out your hook. Back post stitches tend to scrunch down, so it might be worth your while just giving them all a tug just to make sure they're sitting at the top of the stitch, just in case your wraparounds are coming in a little bit lower. I think mine are all okay. It doesn't hurt to just give it a little tug into shape, especially when it's as small as it currently is. You might not want to do this once you've got into the wider rounds. Just give everything a pull into shape in case it is misbehaving. So you can see the beautiful ridges there. Then pop that loop back on your hook, ready to begin round 8. Round 8 is the second of 3 pattern repeat rows. Chain 2, which counts as a double crochet, and then double crochet in the remaining stitches until you hit the chain 2 space. You should have the same amount as you did for the ridge row. So on this ridge row we had 3, so on this following subsequent row after a ridge row, you should have the same number of double crochet stitches on the sides. Then in the chain 2 space, do a large shell, which is 2 double crochet, chain 2, 2 double crochet, all into that top chain 2 space. And we had 3 coming up, including that chain 2. So you want 3 double crochet coming back down. Skip 2 stitches and double crochet back up to the chain 2 space, then place a large shell in that chain 2 space. Double crochet back down the side with the same amount of stitches. So in this row, it will be 3. Skip 2 and crochet back up to the chain 2 space. Repeat this all the way around. To finish round 8, just as we have been doing, slip stitch to join to your initial chain 2 of the round, and then slip stitch into the very next stitch, ready to begin round 9. For round 9, we are going to be doing the same thing again. So chain 2 and double crochet in each stitch up to the chain 2 space. Now there'll be one more stitch on this side section than it was on the row below. So on the row below, we had 3 stitches before the shell. This time we will have 4. There'll always be one more stitch on row 9. Once you hit that chain 2 space, work a large shell. That's 2 double crochet, chain 2, 2 double crochet, all into the same place. Take note of how many stitches it took you to get to this shell section. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And then that is your count for how many you do on the return side. So 4 stitches down the side. Skip 2 and double crochet in the next 4 stitches up to the chain 2 space. Then work a large shell into that chain 2 space. Repeat this all the way around. Once you've finished round 9, slip stitch to the top of that original chain 2. So this blanket, as it gets bigger and has more rows, the weight of it does sort of pull itself out. However, if you want to be super duper perfect, it might be worth giving it a gentle blocking once you have completed your blanket to get it to lie completely flat. But this ridge is going to form a ridge and a divot along the back, which is why it's never going to completely lie flat like a traditional round ripple. However, I absolutely am obsessed with this ridge texture in it. So completely forgive that tiny bit of extra work you may have to do, depending on your tension, how big you take the blanket, all those things. Just bear in mind, might be worth giving it a gentle block if you want to. I personally don't bother, because why block your work if you don't have to? So to continue this blanket, you will simply repeat rows 7, 8, and 9. Row 7 is the small shell back post row. So the ridge is always on the small shell row. Then you follow with 2 large shell rows. You'll add one more stitch on that final row 9, which will increase your stitch count by 1 for when you go on to do the next ripple row. There are some important key things to remember when working a round ripple, either with this ridge here or without the ridge. You always do one small shell row followed by 2 large shell rows. That's what keeps it flat and from ruffling by adding way too many stitches. So always small shell followed by 2 large shell. The other thing that is crucial to keeping your stitch count correct: at the end of each row, once you have slip stitched to that chain 2 to start the next row, always slip stitch into the second stitch. Then chain 2 and start whichever row you are on. Another handy tip, as I've been saying all the way through this tutorial, is however many stitches it then takes you to get to the chain 2 space is how many you'll then do coming back down the other sides and skipping. After a while, You won't even pay attention to these two stitches that you're skipping because they all line up, and just by eye, you'll spot them. But this slip stitching into the next double crochet stitch is crucial for keeping your count correct. So your very next row would be a repeat of row 7, which I have got timestamps for in this video, so you can easily scooch back to watch what we did on row 7 again. But you do your back post double crochet around the next stitch, not this one that the chain 2 came from, but from the very next stitch along. And you work those up to the shell. Then you work your small shell into the top. And then count how many stitches it took. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And repeat that number coming back down. So repeat row 7, 8, and 9. Your stitch count will increase as you continue along your rows. That's absolutely normal. That's what these large shell rows are doing. And make sure you end your blanket on a large shell set of rows. So end on row 9. That will make life easier for you for blocking and will make the whole thing lie nice and flat. You can, of course, end on this small shell row if you want to, but it will give you a bit of a funny bumpy edge. So definitely end ideally on these last two rows. So after you've done the next ridge row, which is row 7, you'd go on to do row 8, which is a large shell row, and row 9, another large shell row. Then come back again, ridge, large shell, large shell, ridge, large shell, large shell, for as big as you want your blanket to be. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope you go on to make beautiful textured ridged round ripple blankets of your own. So until next time, happy crocheting!